Hi friends, this is Harinaganand Idumudi. If you want to get more updates, please subscribe our channel. Our channel name is Short and Hub. If you want to join in my WhatsApp group, please send a message to 9704455002 informing your state and name, etc. Our channel has been providing both general and legal dictations ranging from 60 words to 200 words per minute, along with advanced outlines for all examinations which are conducted by the Staff Selection Commission, court including High Court and Supreme Court, RRB and other state and central government examinations to improve speed in stenography. Further, our channel has been providing dictations on current affairs which never dictated on any YouTube channel. Important links are available in the description box. Get ready for shortened dictations at 100 words per minute of Kailash Chandra sir. Transcription number 63, 5 minutes speed, 5 seconds left. Start. You have rightly stated that the principle of this bill has been unanimously accepted by the House and most of the relevant points have been made out, and that no time of the House should be taken by repeating the same points again and again. One of the points on which I want to lay stress and which is being disputed again and again by the Treasury benches is the question of cottage industries. Though you pointed out to them yesterday that there is provision in this bill to take into consideration the cottage industries also, and the Honorable Deputy Minister realized it again, there was a point raised by Mr. Shiva today, and the Honorable Speaker, who was in the chair at the time, said that the scope of the bill is confined only to the consideration of protection to industries as against foreign industries, that is to give protection to the indigenous industries as against imported goods, and the question of cottage industry doesn't come in here. The Honorable Deputy Minister detailed this. Unless protection is given to indigenous industries, we shouldn't be able to develop industrially. I wholeheartedly supported this proposition. I am not against it. When I speak of cottage industries, I do not for a moment think that our country should not be developed on the same lines as the other countries in the world. I want that every villager should have the same amenities that we sitting in this house have. Every villager should have these furnitures, fittings, houses and so on. The only thing is that the existing economy should not be disturbed and sacrificed before substitute arrangement is made. Before we give protection to any bigger industries, the first thing we should consider is that the materials which are at present being produced in our villages to meet the requirements of our villages and on which the economic life of the villagers rest are properly safeguarded. We should see that we have sufficient quantity of consumer goods to meet the necessities of all people in the country, and nothing is done merely in the interest of 10% of the people at the sacrifice of existing village economy before making sure of some better substitute. I find that at the present moment our attention is confined to the amenities and requirements of a portion of the population only. The other day, my honorable friend, whom I regard as a great economist and who knows finance, etc., and looks to the interests of the country and gives very good advice, said that we do not go to medieval's age, and the luxury of yesterday is the necessity of today, and that few articles which we import today from many foreign countries and the few industries which we are starting for recreation and amenities of the people should not be guarded. I agree with him. Stop.